So, I'm Susan Milius, the biology writer at Science News, and I've had a very bizarre and entertaining year writing about mosquitoes, of all things. Mosquitoes suddenly mattered. You could have conversations with people at dinner parties about mosquitoes. Some of the most interesting conversations I had were with researchers who talked about what we don't know about mosquitoes. Which mosquitoes actually carry Zika? The World Health Organization and the CDC have long been saying that it's the Aedes aegypti mosquito and another Aedes relative. But there's been talk in Brazil that maybe there's a very different genus of mosquito, the southern house mosquito, which is a Culex mosquito, that might actually be spreading it, and nobody's been paying much attention to them. The results have been mixed. This would turn everything upside down. We might have to rethink a lot of how it might spread, where it might spread, whether it would spread. Whether a mosquito can spread a disease is very different from whether it actually will, because mosquitoes have tastes like everybody else. There's a big question about what the Culex mosquitoes actually like to bite. I mean, who's the sort of cream puff, the chocolate of mosquito, and who's the broccoli, with respect for broccoli, of course. So I think 2017 is going to be an exciting time as people sort out how they feel about using genetically modified insects for mosquito control. Key West has become just a storm center for debate about this. The mosquito control people in Key West have decided that they are going to have a test of genetically modified mosquitoes. This would be the first genetically modified mosquitoes to flap through U.S. air. What's ahead for 2017 is that they are going to relocate the test and find another area within the same county where people aren't as upset by it. And then this requires going back through government regulations again. There's been a great deal of fuss about this as an experiment in the U.S., but it's not so experimental anymore outside the U.S. Brazil has had free-flying genetically modified mosquitoes for several years now, and they've been released in other countries too. This is not the first free-flying genetically modified insect to be released in the U.S. That was the pink bollworm out in the Southwest. So there seems to be something about a mosquito that just gets people upset. We talk about the mosquito when it's actually lots of mosquitoes, and there are 3,500 species in the world. Some of them don't like blood. Some of them are reportedly pretty. Some of them actually are important to ecosystems, like a carnivorous plant. The pitcher plants have their own sort of pet mosquitoes. It's sort of sad that we don't recognize the great diversity of mosquitoes out there. I mean, you think that, I mean, they're an animal that everybody recognizes, and I don't think anybody has them on their curtains and pajamas when they're kids or has stuffed mosquitoes, as a general rule.